Especially as of late, there's been a lot of talk of GNOME dropping the X11 session, with the current version at this stage basically being the end of the line for the X11 session, with the next version going Wayland only, and the code for X11 being stripped out henceforth. So that might be done in GNOME 50, it might be done in GNOME 70. It kind of depends on how much people want to strip the code out, what sort of effect it's going to have on the rest of the code base. I wouldn't be surprised if it's gone by 50, but we'll have to wait and see. But what about the KDE world? We are seeing distros like Kubuntu with 25.10 going Wayland only, following mainline Ubuntu. And Arch Linux recently split the Plasma package in two, now making the X11 session entirely optional, so you can run a system that is now Wayland only Plasma. Manjaro is following suit and doing the same thing as well. But what's the go in upstream KDE? Are they planning to drop X11 support anytime soon? Is there something maybe you and I don't know about yet that could indicate that possibly happening? And I'm sure there's something going on behind closed doors. I'm sure there's some discussions about when exactly they want to do it, but not to the extent so far of X11 actually seriously being dropped. And recently, Nate Graham of the KDE Project made a post about exactly this, about Plasma's X11 session. So the current status is Plasma's X11 session continues to be maintained. Emphasis on current, because this very well may change, and asterisk above maintained, because there are some important caveats with what that actually means. Specifically, that means we'll make sure Plasma continues to compile and deploy on X11, so we'll make sure it continues to actually work, right? Like, it actually functions. Bug reports about Plasma X11 session being horribly broken, for example, you can't log in, will be fixed. Other examples being things like an immediate crash or Windows not being out of spawn, things like that. Things that make the X11 session entirely unusable. Very bad X11 specific regressions will be fixed eventually. What does eventually mean? One day, when someone gets around to it, when they feel like it. There's not really any clear timeline on this happening because they just don't really have that many people who want to work on the X11 side. Things that fall under this category would be things like the custom hotkey system breaking or screenshots no longer working under X11. You can keep using the X11 session without these working. It's just not as pleasant. Less bad X11 specific bugs will probably not be fixed unless someone pays for it, linking over to the consultants page. So, this would be things like themes not rendering correctly, weird extra resource usage, things like that, where it's not really that big of a deal. It probably should be dealt with if somebody wants to do it. And if somebody wants to volunteer to do it for free, they can do so. It's just the KDE devs are probably not going to work on it themselves. And X11 specific features will definitely not be implemented unless someone pays for it. Because if you add new features, that means that someone has to actually go and maintain the feature. This is actually not too bad. There are relatively few open and fixable X11 specific bugs, 0.76% of all open bug reports as of the time of writing. Now, 0.76% might not sound like much. Keep in mind the KDE project, the Plasma project, is really big. So that is still right down the bottom here. Oh, it was 188. Now it's 187 open bugs. That's still a lot, but in the context of the whole project is a very tiny amount. And when I went looking today, there were only two Bugzilla tickets requesting new X11 specific features that needed closing. Most bugs and features are platform agnostic, so X11 users will benefit from all of these that get fixed and implemented. This is the most important part. Just because it's X11 specific stuff that's probably not gonna be addressed, doesn't mean nothing's gonna change on the X11 side. They're not going to hold back things that are cross-platform just because it's also on the X11 side. If it's cross-platform, both sides are going to improve. Now, because they're mainly focusing on the Wayland side, those cross-platform changes may introduce new regressions in the X11 side, and some of those regressions might be less bad bugs or X11-specific things, and probably won't end up being addressed. So whilst it's true that both platforms are going to improve, mainly the testing is being done with the Wayland side. Eventually, it's lights out for X11 though, right? When will that happen? X11's upstream development has dropped off significantly in recent years. I wouldn't even say recent years. I think the peak was in 2007, and since then has basically trended downward, at least until the X Libre developer came along. Now, this is without taking into account like all of the reverts that may be done, but even with the reverts that have been done so far, I think it brings it up to like 2015, 2014 numbers, somewhere around that point. So nowhere near the actual peak of the project. And X11 isn't able to perform up to the standards what people expect today with respect to HDR, which is a very recent expectation. This is something I remember covering like 5-6 years ago when there were just conferences trying to be done to solve the HDR problem. Valve says, we want to make an HDR Steam Deck. Problem gets solved in a matter of months. 10 bits per color monitors, other fancy monitor features, multi-monitor setups, especially with mixed DPIs or refresh rates. You already could do multi-monitor stuff on X11, no problem there whatsoever. It gets a bit funky with this part though. Multi-GPU setups, screen tearing. This is something you can technically, theoretically solve on the X11 side. It's just kind of inconsistent, and NVIDIA stuff never really properly solved it. Security. The security thing is more of a developer concern, and I don't think the devs have ever really done a great job at selling it. Security is important, but when users see they're missing features, and the reason why they're missing a feature is security, like, it's not really a great explanation why that's an improvement on what was there before. Crash robustness, input handling, and much more. Now, when it comes to actually dropping the X11 session from upstream Plasma, not dropping it in the distros, but actually dropping it in the project, as I've said before, there's currently no firm timeline for this, and I currently don't expect it to happen in the next year, or even the next 2 years, but that's just a guess, and when it does happen, you're probably gonna hear about it well in advance. I'll make a video about it. Nate will probably make some sort of article about it. I'll probably drag Nate onto the podcast again to talk about it and all this sort of stuff. It depends on how quickly we implement everything on this list right here, the Wayland known significant issues. These are not necessarily just nice to have things. These are things that are considered generally hard blockers by the project. KDE is being incredibly conservative here and is going to most likely keep the X11 session around until everything on this list, and also this list over here, which I'll talk about in just a moment, is resolved. So if you're worried about going to Wayland before everything is ready, KDE is the place you should be supporting. So, we have things like session restoration. There is some various things with keyboards. I think the biggest thing here is the graphics tablet list, which isn't necessarily that graphics tablets worked amazingly on X11, but going into Wayland, we have a chance to actually make graphics tablets really, really good on Linux. Of course, there is some accessibility stuff, and most importantly, there is a bunch of upstream stuff that they can't fix themselves. They can certainly get involved in the discussions, but it's in some cases missing protocols or things they're not involved in, like the NVIDIA case. And yeah, kind of going to take a bit of time and a bit of work alongside them as well. Now, this is just the baseline to get everything where they are happy. To actually fully drop X11, there is some additional stuff that needs to be done as well. And this is where some things which you don't often hear talked about is included. Notably, things like a task automation system. So something equivalent to XDO tool. There are things like YDO tool, but it does require root access. And they want to make something basically, you know, that gives you that level of control within KDE. How exactly they're going to approach that is unclear, whether it's some new portal that's developed, whether it's something using internal KDE APIs. Unlikely, but it would be nice to see something actually upstreamed into Wayland, and then it's something everybody can make use of. Now, why are they doing this? Why are they working towards dropping X11? Eventually. Not anytime soon, but eventually. the Plasma team isn't emotional about display servers. Now, I don't know if this is intentional. I've spoken to Nate many times. He's a cool dude. He's really nice. And he feels like he'd be too nice to just, like, put this into a post. But this feels like a dig at all of the people just losing their minds about X11. Losing their minds about X11 being dropped from projects. But also people playing the role of, like, the maniacal supervillain talking about how they're trying to kill off X11. I don't know if it's intentional, but I'm gonna laugh about it nonetheless. It's just obvious that X11 is in the process of outliving its usefulness. And that's not because of the age of the project, unlike some people seem to think is the reason why X11 is being dropped. It's not being dropped because it's old. That's stupid. Someday Wayland will be in this boat too. Such is the eventual fate of all technologies. This, I hope, is a much more sort of gradual change, where rather than going from X11 to Wayland, we have this process of slowly adopting new protocols into Wayland, slowly changing things out, having new protocol versions, and then even though it's still called Wayland, the Wayland of today and the Wayland 30 years from now are entirely different systems. In addition to the fact that Wayland is better for modern hardware, maintaining code to interact with two display servers and session types is exactly as unpleasant as it sounds. Our resources are always limited, so we're looking forward to the day where we can once again focus on programming for a single display server paradigm. It will mean that everything else can improve just a little bit faster. And I think this is a big part of the reason why we have been seeing more progress on Wayland. Now that most people have just come to accept that Wayland is the direction things are going, like, yes, there's going to be people that hold on to X11. I know that X Libre is now in the Artix repos, at least in staging or testing, one of the two. But, like, most other people, especially those working on the desktops, have accepted that Wayland is the way we're going to be doing things. So you're seeing, like, just less and less and less focus on the X11 side, and more of that focus can be shifted over to fixing Wayland problems that still legitimately exist. Now, let's just sidetrack to this heading here. Regardless of when you pull the trigger, isn't it premature? I know he's being facetious, but let's just take it, like, way too literally. Imagine we're in a world where Wayland does every single thing that X11 does. It is fully one-to-one compatible. This is not the direction we're going in, but just imagine that world, and then it does more things on top of that. At that point, there would be zero justification for keeping the X11 side around. Like, it would actually just not make any sense. Obviously, though, not exactly the direction we're going in. Most major distros have already moved their Plasma sessions to Wayland by default, including Arch, Fedora, KDE Neon, Kubuntu, and Kubuntu is actually going Wayland only, as I mentioned, and generally their downstream forks as well. As I mentioned with Manjaro, they are going Wayland default, not Wayland only. The package is still going to be available in the repos. Several others whose roadmaps I'm familiar with plan to do so in the near future. At this point in time, our telemetry says, telemetry, by the way, is off by default. You have to choose to enable it unless your distro goes and enables it for you. Anyway, says the majority of Plasma users are already using the Wayland session. Currently, 73% of Plasma 6 users who have turned on telemetry are using the Wayland session, and a little over 60% of all telemetry activating users, that includes people on Plasma 5, are on Wayland. But if you're still on Plasma 5, what would you even be running at this point? I guess if you have a Steam Deck that's not updated, that would be on Plasma 5. Because recently, they did move over to Plasma 6 with SteamOS 3.7. And when that happened, the Plasma 6 users on Wayland went from 82% down to 73%. Why did that happen? Because I'm not sure why, but Valve has decided that in SteamOS 3.7, they're still going to use the X11 session by default. I would imagine they've probably done some internal testing and they're not exactly at the point where they're happy to make it the default on a device they're actually selling. Obviously, the desktop mode isn't the main thing in SteamOS, but it is being offered and they want it to be, you know, at the level they want it to be at. To be fair though, Valve is paying for work to be done on KDE, so it's probably gonna get to the point where they choose to enable it by default anyway. To a large extent, this is up to the distros, not us, it wouldn't make sense for us to get rid of Plasma's X11 support while there are still major distros shipping by default. And likewise, it won't make sense for us to keep it around long after those distros have moved away from it. This is a stance that I can really, really respect. They are not trying to push people to go to Wayland as quickly as possible. As I said, they are being incredibly conservative here and want to make sure things are in basically as good of a state as they can possibly be in, and then pull the trigger. Because if the downstreams aren't happy with Wayland in its current state in the Plasma session, all you're doing is creating animosity between the projects. In Plasma's case, they are trying to have a healthy relationship with their downstreams and understand why they may not have defaulted yet, why they might still have users on the X11 side, and try to solve those problems. Once every major distro has swapped by default, or better yet, only offering the Wayland session, you can say with pretty good confidence that your downstreams are happy with this move being made. I think people forget that there's supposed to be a community here. There is supposed to be, like, people working together, talking back and forth, and trying to work out how do we best move things forward together, not we're gonna just call the shots. Is Plasma's Wayland session perfect? No. What is? Final Fantasy X. Is it better than X11 session in literally every way? Also no. Is it better in most ways that matter to most people? The numbers say yes. Now, you're not a number, you are not a statistic, and you might still like the X11 session in the current state it's in, and think maybe there is something missing on the Wayland site that you really, really want. And that's totally okay. You're the reason why we're still maintaining the X11 session. We're going to try very hard to not get rid of it until you're happy. Ultimately, that's the goal here. Make everyone happy. Now, that's a goal that's never going to be possible because there's some people who they make it their life mission to not be happy. But everybody who's willing to be happy, make those people happy. This includes people who have mixed DPI / refresh rate multi-monitor setups or laptop touchpads, as well as people using auto key or graphics tablets with dials on them. Long transitions like this are tough, but ultimately worth it, so that we all get something better in the end. This right here, this is why I respect the KDE project, I really respect Nate, and honestly, I would like to see even more people use KDE. I know right now I am a Neri user, I'm a weird window manager guy, all this sort of stuff. Yes, I get that. But if I'm going to use a desktop environment, if I'm going to recommend a desktop environment, in its current state, KDE is what I'm always going to recommend. Now, over on the GNOME blogs by Jordan Petrus, there is a very similar post about X11 removal. Basically, the format is copied from what Nate did, and he openly admits that. Pretty much saying what I already said, where next version is going Wayland only, they explain why Wayland only is happening and all this sort of stuff, but most of it we've already pretty much said throughout this video. If you'd like to read that, I will leave both the posts linked in the description down below, so feel free to go and do so. So, what are you currently running? I've run polls on my audience and the majority of people are using Wayland. Now, when I ran the poll, it wasn't just specifically KDE, it was KDE, GNOME, you know, WLRoots, Hyperland, all this other sort of stuff. Whatever else is out there, what are you actually using? So let me know. If you are a KDE user, right now, are you on the X11 side? Are you on the Wayland side? And if you are on the X11 side, what is keeping you on the X11 side? And if you haven't tried it recently, try out the Wayland side and just see what it's like. So, if you liked the video, go like the video. If you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe to LiberaPay, link in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and I'm sure there's going to be some fantastic comments about X11 and Wayland. I'm sure. What?